is swim without the mm?
Swim.
Beautiful job. Awesome out of your way. I love that. What is swim without the woo? Say. No, that's okay.
Sim.
Perfect. All right.
You can thank Donna for this.
Say the same. If you can say each sound, it's going to help you out. What is step without the s? Don't say that s. I got it. What's the next sound?
Tap. Tap. Tap.
Beautiful. And the only thing I would change, tiny bit, keep those eyeballs down here, okay? These are our placeholders. Those letters aren't there, which makes it about 16 times more challenging.
Right.
That's beautiful because, of course, you need your eye very well. So that was beautiful.
Right.
But if you keep your eyes down, these are placeholders there. That's awesome. Good job, Mark. What is step without the p? Say my pun. You're close. Say it again. Tell me each sound if you would.
Step.
Nice.
Step.
Step. Not a real word.
Right. Right. I know.
What is step without the t? Nice! What's slap without the pump?
Slop. Slop.
Without the pump?
I know.
Slop. Nice.
Slop.
What's slap without the O? Nice. See,
stop.
The less you think, the better it goes. That's beautiful. Tell me the sounds in grab.
Gur.
Gur is two. What's the first sound in? What's the first sound in gur?
Gur.
Gur. What do you hear first? What do you hear me say?
Gur.
What do you hear me say right here? Gur. Tell me sounds in grab.
Well, I mean.
Which is cool. We're going to second. It's true. What do you
think?
And you know what you know? You know that what letter goes there in grab, right? You know what?
Yes.
It's the letter G. And the first sound in the letter being G. Sounds in G are G E. So you're thinking of that letter that's going to be there. You're thinking the letter G, that's going to be a J. Now, once in a blue one, that can be a J, but then this word would be drab, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what do your ears hear me say right here? Grab. What am I going to say right here? Just say
go.
And it sounds like grab.
Go. Grab.
Nice. What's grab without? He's a tricky dude because he loves to be stuck with everybody else, okay?
Right.
So he's the toughest one, all right? Because you're doing such a great job. I had to challenge you.
That's okay.
Grab with me. Do that. Grab without the word. Say that.
Go. Grab.
next chapter that you're going to read, we're going to spell it purple. Cereal. What's the first syllable in C-E-O?
Sear.
Yep. What's next?
E-O.
Beautiful. Sounds in sear. What's our first?
Sear.
E. What's our next sound again? Sear.
Sear.
Tell me the sounds in sear again.
Ear.
Say E.
E.
Tell me again.
E-er.
Beautiful. Sear.
Sear.
What's our next sound? Sear, E-O. Sear, what's this one?
E.
Then what?
Sear, E-O.
Just O, right?
Just O.
Yeah. So you're going to show me what you think the spellings are. There's some funky spellings in here on purpose. I'm hoping that there'll be some things that I can teach you. You show me what you think, and I'm going to show you all the correct answers. You're just going to say the sounds as you write.
Okay.
Okay? Say as you write, sear.
Sear.
So say, what's that first sentence? You have to show me a S. What's the next sound? Sear. Just say E.
E.
And what's next? Sear. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Sear. What's our next sound here? And sear.
E.
Say as you write, E. Say it.
E.
Yep. Right when the hand is writing, Mark, I want your mouth to say it. Say E.
E.
Beautiful. Sear, E. What's next?
O.
And this is like the Rice Krispies cereal. Sear, E.
O.
Now you're sear. Beautiful job with those sounds. Here, this is going to be, this is the most common way to spell. So that was a really smart choice. But in this word, this is your spelling for s. Right? So go ahead and write that and say s. Yep. And then put a little circle around it. One line under it. One line to show you that that's going to be your s. E-er, we've got this. E. Beautiful. This is sear e o. Stick your tongue out at me and say o.
O.
I want to see your tongue. O. 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 Like laugh. Say laugh.
Laugh.
Now say, ooh, ooh, yeah, that's a little bit, so that, oh, and ooh, a lot of people use that one, but this is Siri, ooh, it's a ooh spelling, okay?
That's no.
It's a ooh, and actually this is at the end, each piece has a vowel, vowel spelling, vowel sound. At the end, when you have ooh, like hospital, or durable, or, you know, level, little, ooh at the end is a vowel spelling. So this is actually our vowel spelling, even though the sound's ooh. Right, write those two letters and say ooh. Say oh right now. Oh,
and I have my troubles with my L's.
Yep, and that's okay. We're just gonna make it.
I'm just letting the people know.
Yes, but that's well that articulation thing, and that's what you've heard. It sounds like oh, but frankly, you've not seen it yet. Oh. So this is what shifts that and how you say it too.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Circle that whole spelling, please.
Okay.
Two lines under that. All right. So you need to remember this is gonna be how we spell s. You got your E or E. And then your two-letter O. Do you want to leave the lines in circles, or do you want us to raise the O?
Just say your O off.
All right, take your O off.
Go for adjustment.
All right, sounds like a good plan. Say your right, cereal. Let me hear you.
Cereal.
Wait, hold on. I want every single sound. So just that. Now your E.
E.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Keep it close. That E spelling right here. Yep, sear E.
O.
Oh, and that's one, it's like such a weird word. Cereal, what is that? So Cocoa Puffs used to be a good word, but now it's good. I think it's still like
cereal.
Cereal, yeah, put your fingers there. You like cereal?
Sometimes.
Like I eat a lot of cherries from my house. Okay, there's blueberry cherries. That's kind of exciting. Cereal, got it. Isn't that a weird word?
Yes, that is.
It's really, really good. That was amazing. Beautiful job, thank you. Okay, we're going to do a bit of a longer one, cautiously. What are your syllables in cautiously? That's the first time you're right. What's the whole syllable in
cautious?
In this next piece, that's the first time you're so good at those sounds. Cautiously. Cautious. What's this piece? Yep, so I want the whole piece though. That's the first sound, which I like. I want the whole syllable. Cautious. Say shus.
Cautious.
Cautious. Beautiful. Sounds in caw.
Caw.
What's your first sound? Shus. What's your first sound in shus? Nice. Ka, shus, shus. Sound in lee.
Lee.
What's your first sound in
lee?
Nice job, Mark. Beautiful. Show me what you think the spellings are. Cautious.
Cautious.
Sage, you're in ka. What's your first sound in ka? Show me a k. tell me, what sound are you saying right here?
Lee.
What sound is this one after the O? What sound is that? Say E. Write that letter you had the first time, and then, but say E as you write it, please. Gosh, this is a beautiful job. This is gonna be your awesome. August is my birthday, no? Okay, let's start with that aw too. That's homecoming aw. Write that and say aw. Nice aw. Just aw, because we don't have a tilde, just aw. No, you're right. That's absolutely right. Just say aw. Put a circle around it, two lines on it. Nice. Two lines to show you that there's two letters. Caw. Your sh. This guy loves being sh at the beginning of a word, like shop and shape and I don't know. Shoe, I guess.
Right.
Or at the end, like in wish or patch. Not very commonly are you going to see this in the middle of a word, all right? Especially
okay.
A multi-syllable word. It doesn't like it there too much. This dude is the top dog for the spelling of sh in the middle of a word. Okay, we just remove that.
Okay.
So I want you to write those two letters, and it's really critical, Mark, that as you're writing them, your mouth is saying sh. Fantastic. Can you put a circle around that? A brain memory helper in two lines. And remember that that's our sh. Now, if we took away the lee here, cautious is a root word, right? Be careful. So when you hear before s and it's in the last syllable toward the end, this is by far the most common way to spell okay? This is going to be our spelling before that s in bigger words. So write both of those, please, and say Say Nice. Yep. And put a circle around that guy. Two lines under. Good job. Cautious. Bold. And you had your E, and you know what? You were right here. This is the spelling at the end, but when you write that one, this is really important because this guy is so popular at the end, especially in bigger words when there's another syllable, as our spelling for E. So I'm going to get rid of this one, and I want you to write this and ensure your mouth is saying E. Right as your hand is writing. Go ahead and do that. Yeah, that messes with your brain. Huh? That's not how I thought of that. Put a circle around the E spelling. One line under, just one letter. Now this word is kind of crazy and it has a lot of things to remember. Are you okay if we leave the lines and circles?
Yes.
As little helpers on this side,
right.
And then we'll write it out together. Okay, so
cook,
you need to remember that. Aw. Our fun shh. You can see that all over, but you're gonna be driving home like, oh my gosh, look at there's a shh right there in whatever nation or whatever that you see on the side.
Right.
You'll start seeing this guy everywhere. Okay, that's gonna be your shh.
Okay.
This is your and your O, and that E is really a popular dude at the end, okay? Cautiously. If there's anything where we forget, I'm going to help you with it, okay? Say it cautiously. I'm hearing it.
Caw.
So what's that first sound? Yep, thank you. What's next in caw? It's two letters.
Yes.
What would you think? And if it's different, I'll show you. Aw.
Aw.
Now shus. And what was our shh? Say it.
Shh.
Yes.
Shush.
Now just say shh. Shh. Beautiful job. Shh. What's next in shus? Next inch. Yep, we got a two letter up. Yep, just what you think? Say up. Say up. Sh. Another is this. Beautiful. Cautious. Now lee.
Lee.
Which percent? Lee. Good. Oh, that's nice and lee.
E.
You can say E. As your hand's writing it.
E.
Good job. Now, with this dude, this guy is actually our and this one is our ah. I love that you pulled both of those guys out of your brain. We're just going to kind of switch them around because I got backwards.
Mm-hmm.
This is your ah, okay?
Okay.
Like in the word this August or fault or whatever. This is ah. Write that and say ah. Yeah, right as your hand is ready. Now say ah. That helps your brain remember. Now right under here, I wanted just a little smiley face. Two eyes and a mouth right under there just to show your brain. Hey, brain, this is our ah, okay?
Yep.
Now over here. We're going to put our and this is your Write that and say Yeah. A little smiley face for that
okay.
So I love that you pulled both of those guys out. So this is our and this is our Have you got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Are you good to get rid of the whole thing?
No.
You want to leave it again? Okay.
No.
We'll leave it again. Beautiful job. Thank you for letting me know that. Okay. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Cautiously. Go for it. Stage questions. Let's hear it. What's your first sound of cock? What's next? What are your ears here right here? Caw. Now shush. Nice, Mark. Just say that shh. What's next? What's next? That's a sick. This guy's just gonna be a s. Write him and say s. Shus. Write that again. Your head right.
No, I just
gotta. Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Rest. Okay. You doing okay?
Yes.
Need a break?
No.
Okay. Write that and just say s. Oh, you had that other. That can be a s. Okay. E-R-Y is next. But that other s that you had.
Yeah.
Show me that s. This one. Yep. There you go. Beautiful. Ha. Shus. You've got everything perfect. Beautiful job. Leave. Don't. Phenomenal, right? Are you okay with us getting rid of it this way and all together?
I guess so.
All right, let's do it. What the heck? What's the worst that can happen, right? I'm going to fall off the cliff, right? All right, I'm here to help you. No worries. Stage right cautiously. Let's hear what you're hearing. Caw, say that could. Just uncaw. You wait till you get to that, but now when you start to write it, say that shh. You're right. Write that, say shh. It's nice and shh. Say oh. Oh, that's, you got the right letters. I'm gonna just be a little persnickety because you're
that's
so good.
Okay.
Right? No. And say oh.
You guys were right.
You're doing it right. Like, say oh. Oh, hold on. Now I went deaf over here. Say my hearing aid here. Say oh.
Okay.
Tell me again. Say you.
It.
Say that here.
Yeah.
Let's put those together. You say it faster.
Yeah.
Say it probably just yeah.
Yeah.
Man, cover this lip, follow your mouth.
Yeah.
We have now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, say it again. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yet. Beautiful. Put it with your brill. Say brill.
Brill. Brilliant.
Woo! Good job. Good job. That's awesome. I know this is weird. This is weird. That's like this spelling. Yes, you are discovering a lot of different spellings for sounds. You've done. It's a great word. Beautiful. It's beginning our story. Say. Let's smush those together. Say it faster. We just push together. That's what we do with all words. The crazy woman, right? When you're feeling anxious, your brain is like, okay, but and then you're moving through it and pushing through it. It's really good. It's really admirable right here.
Great.
Are you ready?
Born that way.
Born ready. Let's see.
Okay.
much, I mean, that's big, and it's nice, like, you pointed it before. What an interesting word, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Learn all kinds of stuff when you're reading from a book, it's pretty cool. Okay, tell me your sound.
E.
Say F.
F. X.
X.
S. No, S.
You're right, S.
Side. Side.
Go with your X.
X, side.
X, side.
X, side. Id.
T. Yeah.
Id.
D. Say t. Id. Put those two together.
Tid.
Tid. Just say tid, and we're going to put this at the bottom of the screen. Just to say tid. Just say tid. Tid.
Tid.
Tid. Beautiful. Id. Excited.
Excited.
Word?
Excited.
Excited. Beautiful. Excited about how well you're reading. Beautiful job.
Yes.
All right. All right. Now I'm going to put this down on the here so they can see. And if there's anything you're not sure of, I'm going to turn this over so it's blank. Okay. And if there's anything you're not sure of, I'm just going to help you around.
Okay. The reason why I use this card is because I don't want to. My eyes are wandering.
Yep.
And I'm trying to find out what the words that I don't know of.
Mm-hmm. They're down here, yes. So those are correct. This is a great plan. I love it. You know, the only thing that would make it even greater, let's turn around so the hole's at the bottom.
Okay. It's very.
This is full.
Simple.
Yep.
Okay.
It's very simple.
It's very simple. The animals say.
Yeah, now there's no z over here, so we're just going to say animal.
Animal.
So start with the.
Okay. The animal said Chris was 12 years old again and having breakfast at home. Across the table sat the red coyote.
Okay, beautiful. Now, if you need a favor, Mark, I want you to put your finger underneath it. You're going to be my teacher, and you're going to move your finger nice and smooth underneath his words, and I'm going to read this back to you, and then you're going to move it again. Okay? So put your pointer finger underneath here, and nice and smooth. As I go, keep up with where my words are. Okay? Ready? My turn now, and then it's going to be your turn, okay?
Okay.
Excuse me. It's very simple, the animal said. Chris was 12 years old again, and having breakfast at home, across the table sat the red coyote. Right?
Okay.
Let me hear you now. You can use your finger or not. You can just follow my pencil.
It's very, very simple. The animal said, Chris was 12 years old again, and having breakfast at home, across the table, set the red coyote.
Coyote.
Okay. You saw a. You see the coyote was saying, I have a had.
What's up here?
Have.
Mm-hmm.
Have.
"You see," the coyote was saying, "I have a baby quota to meet." "Is it large?" queried Chris asked. "Oh, yes, quite large. However, I can tell you that baby Jeanette never felt a thing." I'm so curious, coming in the middle of this book, what the heck is going on here. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, your turn. I'm serious.
"You see," the coyote was saying, "I had a baby. Have a baby. Quota to meet."
Let's read this part again with that. I'm going to read it with me. Okay. "I have a baby quota to meet." And here's.
Okay. "I have a baby quota to meet. It is this."
Is, okay. Say your sounds. Is, okay.
Is this luck?
Say it.
Yeah.
It. Mm-hmm. You got it. You're doing great, sweetheart. Yeah.
That's okay.
Is it
large?
Nice. I like how you did that with a question.
Chris asked. "Oh, yes, quite large. However, I can tell you that baby Jeanette never felt a thing. The animal rose raised one paw to show Chris. Oh, I placed this.
Nice.
This paw generally. Gently over her mouth. The coyote said, "I am quite expert."
Nice.
"Expert at this such sort of things."
Thing. That's what I was
saying.
Thing.
Thing.
Thing. Job, that's what we have. Okay.
Okay.
Finger underneath and no, we already did Jeanette. Okay. Okay. Under the, my turn. Okay. "The animal raised one paw to show Chris. Oh, I placed this paw gently over her mouth," the coyote said. "I am quite expert at this sort of thing." Okay. What is this? Is this like that there's a giver? Anyway, I'm kind of like, I'm so curious. All right, let's hear it.
"The animal raised one paw to show Chris. Oh, I placed this paw gently over her mouth. The coyote said, I am quite experienced. Expert at this sort of things. Thing."
Nice job. Good catch. Can you tell me what's going on so you know what's happening?
Okay, this boy here, Chris, got caught in an avalanche. He's probably in there about 4 or 5 days. He had an air hole, and he's being, he's having nightmares. I like to say another.
Okay. Hallucinations, kind of? Is that
yes.
Okay.
That's the word I want to use.
Okay.
And,
so these animals aren't really there.
Right. And then this Jeanette was his baby, or was his big sister that she died of sudden crip. Sudden crip.
Sudden death.
Crip death. Yes.
Death.
Yeah, and then he's the youngest. He's the youngest boy.
So he's hanging out in the avalanche.
In a snow tube.
Oh goodness, he's having these. I'm really kind of happy that he's not. I don't know what's going on. But very good, nice. Thank you for catching me up. All right, let's read a little bit more. Here,
okay. "Oh, I don't think you're ready," flat. Oh, yes, more, many.
Thank you.
Many people will try to
And this is at the end, you have a choice of I or E. This one is I. Read that back. We're going to just read this paragraph back, and then we'll be done.
Okay.
Just put this down here while I read. You put your finger to the
mm-hmm.
Do you want to do all of it? Should we start up here? Down here? This here?
Whatever you want to do.
Oh, sorry. The coyote laughed. Oh, yes. Many people try to deny me, but it's no use. You and I, for example, have an appointment in a few years. The coyote lifted the cereal box. May I join you? Lifted the cereal box. May I join you? Very nice. When a word starts with a vowel,
mm-hmm.
instead of a, the word before is going to be an.
Right.
Okay, so that's how we do that. Nice reading. You're doing such a beautiful job. If you could tell me, and I just walked in the room, 10 words, what we read in this page and a half, what would you say went on in just this chapter so far? So who are our main people?
Chris is our main people.
Okay, so Chris is our dude.
Mm-hmm.
And what is going on with Chris?
Chris is.
Or say my sounds.
Chris hard. Is.
What's he doing in this chapter?
In this chapter, he's dreaming.
Why are they talking about this? What's going on with him in his dream?
He's thinking about his sister.
Okay. And who else is a big part in so far what we've read? His sister, and who's he chatting with?
A fox. I mean, a coyote.
Okay. So if we were to make a sentence and we wanted to make it 10 words or less, all right, about Chris. What would you say to me would be a good sentence to tell me? Because I pretend I just didn't just read this. What could you
okay.
tell me?
Chris dreamed about.
Chris dreamed of a red coyote. Can we just say smothering?
Yes.
I guess. What I mean is this killer.
Right.
Say what it is. I guess smothering. But that's what he's doing. We say putting his paw in three words, or we use one word smothering, right?
Right.
Smothering his sister. I love that. That is such a good sentence for a page and a half. I love it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 minutes. Okay, so this is what we're going to do if you're up. write the sentence with my help, or would you like me to write it and you can read it? The sentence that you just created.
Let's have you do it.
Can you do me a favor while I'm doing it? Will you say the sounds for me?
Yes.
Okay, now, every sentence has a capital at the beginning and punctuation at the end. A lot of people my age and your age don't know that, interestingly. So, I'm pretty sure we have a capital at the beginning. So, say as I write Chris.
Yes.
Yes, this do sound say it.
Yeah.
Chris, now dream.
Dream.
What's my first, what's this say?
Did
you say to? Dream of, say as I write of. Weird word, isn't it? Of.
Of.
Now red.
Red.
What's the first sound?
E.
What's the sound here in red?
Red.
Something. Say at. Of a red coyote. So say as I write Now say I.
I.
Weird. Now Kai.
Kai.
Oh, now T. What's it? Nice. I'm a red coyote smothering. Okay, say as I write smothering. What's my first sentence? Say the. Now it. Smothering. His.
His.
Say as I write his.
His.
Say it. Say it.
It.
Say it.
It.
Say it.
It.
His sister. Say his right sis. Say it.
Sis.
Sis. Now turd.
Turd.
What's the first one? Turd.
There's
an er.
Period.
And there's a punctuation at the end. Now I'm going to read this and you're going to read it back. It's a great sentence. Chris dreamed of a red coyote smothering his sister.
Chris dreamed of a red coyote smothering his sister.
Right. Now, I noticed, too, and I talked to Katie about this, too. Look at me a second, Mark. When you're reading this, this is what you're doing. What's moving?
I have to.
Okay. Now, hold
because of my glasses.
Okay. I want you to look at my marker, and I want you to follow with just your eyes, okay? Look at my marker over here. This is called training. Like I would have to crawl if someone wanted to run a mile. I might be able to run half a block, right? So, but because I don't have that stamina, we're going to make your eyes have some more stamina. Okay, so I want you to follow this marker. That was beautiful, by the way. Your eyes aren't used to doing that. Okay, but you're going to get real tired of reading if your head is. Just follow the end of this marker. Here, look at the marker. Now, this is what that feels like. Oh my God. Beautiful tracking. I'm proud of you right there. What about the ophthalmologist? What's that sound here? It's going to make you really tired. You're going to have a 3-hour nap today. Okay? And then, I have a 3-hour nap. I'm going to drive right now. I'm sure you can have a 3-hour nap. So that's good. So I want you, we're going to do this one more time, and I just want you to try it.
Okay.
No matter how long it takes, I want you, even if you have to hold your head, I want you to really think about moving those eyes. I'm going to read it first, and then you're going to read it again. And if you're okay with it, I'll just reach over and touch your forehead to remind you just to move your eyes. Is that okay with you or no?
See, I can't focus here a little bit.
I don't mind you moving your head a tiny bit.
Okay.
I just want you, and I see what you're saying as far as that. But if your head is moving pretty swivelly,
mm-hmm.
right, and it's going to take a lot of energy and it's getting a little tired.
Okay.
Right? So we're just going to practice making it, improving on it and improving on it, and then
okay.
those eyes will be like, woo, look at me go. Okay.
okay.
As far as that. So watch me, and while I do the reading, I just mm-hmm. want you to pay attention with your eyes to watch and try not to move your head, okay? Chris dreamed of a red coyote smothering his sister. Did you follow the words? Because you didn't look at her head. Oh, that was beautiful. Do it?
I didn't do it.
You didn't follow the words?
No.
I was going to say, I said, I saw those eyes moving. Now you're going to read and see what happened. I don't know if you're throwing the leg over there. All right. Are you ready? Your turn.
Chris dreamed of a red coyote smothering his sister.
You did not move your head. Beautiful.